All right, guys. So I just watched the Game of Thrones season finale. Missa. It's pretty late because obviously that takes up like an hour of my life and I've only got an hour to shut up. Right. Basically, I'm not going to do a Let's Build today because I can't be bothered. But what I am going to do is I'm going to show you around this. This is completely not built by me. The majority of the work on this was done by Monster. There's help from people like Spidier, Legionnaire, Craft. I'll put links to everyone that I can over the next kind of day, so they won't all be there as soon as this video is uploaded because it's late and I won't be able to get the links for the channels and stuff, but there's a lot of people that worked on this, so yeah, I can't give credit to one person, but the majority of it, the mastermind behind it and all that sort of stuff, is by Monster. And I can't do a particularly long video on this because I don't know much about it. Like, there's not much I can talk about, but I can show you around and I can show you what looks badass and just kind of make you go, ooh, that's awesome. So let me just adjust some sliders. Okay, so first of all, this is you've seen like me flying around these ships before. This is what is there now, and it's built into this cove, inspired in part by things like Booty Bay from World of Warcraft, and I think that's just about it as far as inspiration goes. On the whole, this is a completely unique build. It's inspired by kind of pirates. It's like Shipwreck Cove from Pirates of the Caribbean. Everything's thrown together, everything's made out of ship roofs, and it's all very kind of nice, as you can see by the greenery and the water and stuff, and lots of cool stuff goes on here. So I'm not quite sure where to start because I haven't actually walked around the streets of this place. So let me just switch to fly speed 1 so I can go a bit slower. It would help if I could speed. Excellent. So we've got cannons here. Before I actually go a step further, I'd like to show you something quickly. This is a plugin that we now use in the server called Weatherman. So if I just type in WM help, so I can remember what to type in, so I haven't used this much, but if I type in WF info, that should work. There we go. Okay, so no, that doesn't work. Never mind. Basically, if I right-click with this, I'll start typing WM wand. There you go. It's just changed a radius of 2 to swampland, as you can see by the thing down the bottom. So if I come over to here, and I think, oh, that doesn't look good, that biome transition. Click a few times, you see I'm actually changing it. Problem is this isn't supposed to be swamp, it's supposed to be, I think WM info is being annoying. Yeah, this is actually supposed to be jungle, so if I type in WM biome jungle, there we go, and also WM bio radius, says something like 5, there we go. So I can right click with this tool and I can in real time update biomes, which is great because before the way you'd have to do it is with World Edit, selecting chunks, obviously just end up with squares everywhere, not good, but this really makes it easier and really nice. So you can see we've got all these nice shit over here. Little docks there, cranes. I'm just going to give you an overview and show you a few shots from kind of street level. Unfortunately, my shaders mod is more and more features of it are breaking every day. I have no idea why. I seriously cannot work that out, but I have to work on that sometime. Fix that. Let me just give you a taster of inside some of the buildings. So everything's very open. Hello. Everything's very open and kind of pretty. Up here, we've got like a little pump design. Wait for it. There we go. So it pumps water into this pool. Also, I love the use of this over here. I don't know why. It's just really cool the way that. That's nice. It's cool. Yeah, this takes a while to actually turn itself off. There we go. This is a blacksmith. Over here, this is the main market. We've got lots of stuff. So everything's like a maze, and I love that. Over here, I don't know what this is. This it would be a pigsty by lots of things, where all the pigs are escaping. So. Maybe they need to work on that. over here, I don't know what this is. It looks like some kind of storeroom. Huge amounts of detail in this build. Really, really nice. The kind of thing you can imagine going around for ages to learn your way around. This is netherrack, but because of the connected textures, we've got like bits of bone sticking out. It looks really gruesome. This is obviously a slaughterhouse of some kind. They can go out here. Further along, we've got custom trees. This is not a custom tree, that's one I did. I just copy pasted it from over there, so that's my cheating attempt. But that tree over there is completely unique. There is some really great stuff that I'm not going to show you yet that you'll love to see later. Look at this, this is the back of a ship here, and this is an entire ship. I barely even noticed it. Here's the gate, you've seen these before. I can't actually do this because it requires two people, but it's the same as the Valgar Fort one. This piece here will go down. That's quite cool. Over here, I don't know what this is. Let's take a look inside. Okay, seems to be some kind of war room. This is, oh, this looks like a sawmill, possibly. Well, you can leave that to your imagination. It's some kind of machinery, anyway. That's cool, I like that. I haven't seen around any of these. Let's go through here. This tree is obviously built by a monster. We're using a plugin, which is kind of like a plugin specifically for World Edit, and it gives you access to loads of new brushes, one of which is the laser brush. I didn't know all of these off by heart, and trying to learn them, but I don't know any of them at the moment. But this laser brush means that you can make these big trees really quite easily when you get the hang of it, and it's very useful for creating them. It's quite cool. Well, it's very cool. So, whoa, how do I even get up to these? Here's a house. Oh yes, I remember this one, I recognise it. Look at the zombie's face. Fucking maggot comes out, wait for it. God, it's nasty. Nasty. There's no. Christ, I haven't seen any of this. This is all amazing. Here's a screenshot that I took a screenshot of this area. It looks like this cannon might have had an accident. And I don't know why that would have blown up, actually. It's a bit weird. Now, there's going to be a ship in here. It goes without saying, the same as the Valgar port. All of these boats out here, just ignore them. These are obviously not going to be staying. But yeah, that's cool. Here's something really cool up here. I love this. So we've got these bits of mast up. There's another one over there. So you climb up this ladder and you look at this place and you're like, oh, I won't be able to walk around here. Oh, perfect fit. So you can fit between a wall and a fence and barely any room to move. So that's great. I love that. It's really cool. It's like the most compact little tower design I've ever seen. It's awesome. Big ass crane here. What else we got? Oh, that's more houses. I think we might have seen this house. Oh, no, actually, no, we haven't. Unless it's mirrored. Nope, not mirrored. Completely unique house. Lots of stuff hanging from the ceiling. Wow. Okay, so maybe turning up my field of view would have been a bit better in this place, because it's a lot of stuff. This is one of like a upturned ship that's kind of makes a shop. Here's the end of the crane with all the pulleys and winches and workings and whatnot. This is a big tower. Right, let's go take a look at the market, and I think I'll wrap up this video because, as I said, I wish I could talk about the process going behind this building. But I guess at the end of the video I will ramble for a little bit about how different types of building really are very different types of building. I've got some signs up saying where things are going to go. Cannonballs. Oh god, look at that. How cozy is that? Oh, come on, this is fantastic. Oh, it's like a maze. Oh, it's so good. Oh, it's so good. I cannot fitting this much stuff into. This is something I just don't think I'll ever be able to do. It's a completely different build style to the way I build. And I really admire this. In some places I feel like it's too cluttered, and I want to try and introduce my way of building, which is very kind of, a lift. There will be a warp for that. I like putting everything into blocks. I like making everything modular, and while randomization is fine, it's fine in my head. It's only fine when it's within a within some kind of structure, and this just has no structure, and it's amazing. Let's just stuff it. I could literally walk around and find new stuff all the way around here, but I will stop showing you around now and just really quickly talk about the two types of building. So monstrous type of building is extremely random. I'm not going to show you this because it's not finished, but fly speed 2. I'm not going to show you around the list because it's not finished, but there's some awesome stuff. For example, just a skull in the roof that you can only see from one angle. Like, come on, that's so good. Here's a fuck off big skull over here. And then everything from beyond here is still in construction, but yeah, you can see how evil this place looks. It reminds me of King Kong. This bit here does. This is where the woman was tied up below, above all these spikes. Yeah, so the Monster style building is extremely randomized, and while you can still see 1, 2, 3 pillar, 1, 2, 3 pillar, it's so broken up that it becomes a completely unique, brilliant way of building, and it allows for these crazy designs, which actually works. So look how well this curve goes into this curve. Really, it's like this is a genius at work. Love it, fucking love it. Yeah. Whereas I build in a much more kind of regimented way. I like everything to be modular. I like to be able to build the same house again and again, say three houses, and then change just sections, neat sections, and make something look completely different. I love that. Anyway, so thanks for watching, guys. This video was longer than I was expecting, but I hope you enjoyed that as much as I did, because I genuinely hadn't seen most of that, and it was really cool. So thanks for watching, and I will see you guys next time.